Okay, here we go. Again. I'm outside of McDonald's here. We made it all the way to Venus, and welcome to Astrology 102. Here she is. Oh my god. Okay. But there's one thing, just one little problem. One little problem. Don't eat your bones. I don't suck on your bones. Or don't look at them, because there's one religion called Buddha. It's Hinduism. Okay? And there's another problem. Don't fall from Rome. I'm gonna say, and you're not gonna like it. I'm not a monk, but this is progressive. You kind of hold that to yourself. I'm Catholic. So I'm Catholic. And I'll be your professor today. And I want you to tell me how many religions there are. Oh my goodness. Muslim, Buddhist, and Hindu. And then there's Catholic, ancient Rome. So we're going to explore this very progressively. Now, Venus is with us now, but we're going to start from there. There are your bones. Or maybe not. Maybe not. Your bones could be there. And I'm a moth. There's nothing I can do. Don't fall from Rome. Okay, so hello McDonald's, how are you doing today? But there's one more, it's called Judaism. Jewish. There was a time where I found a way to bring good news to my people. My people. I'm not Buddha. I'm not Hindu. And I'm certainly not a Muslim. A lot is very hard to understand. Oh, God. Just saying that word is very, very loud. He's very typically fanatical about the way he feels about this problem. And there's nothing here. I said one time, there seems to be a McDonald's here, you know, there's a gas station, there's a place I can get some cigarettes, but where's Allah? Let me tell you, I think he may have gone with the dragon. Now, I don't have any sons, I don't have any daughter, but to simply tell a lie would telling you the truth when I said that there's a dragon in control of all of us. The Apostle Paul wrote a thing about whenever the dragon is talking, that's his problem. You understand there's nothing here to talk about on YouTube, but simply maybe a shared interest and trying to figure this out for ourselves. But there's a dragon here. And this man from Judaism is holding a dragon. Time out. It's huge. You can hear this from about a mile away at this point. It was across the field there. But I want to try to explain the Feast of Jupiter the best I can. I don't have any wine. I don't have anything to eat, but I'm going to go catch some fish, and I'm going to try to see if I can find a bottle of wine that I want to drink. I want to drink this bottle of wine myself. Okay, so here's the part that we don't really understand is people talking over us and telling us strange things. It would take a cabal or a Sikh to understand how to control the world. But we want forecast. We want to be able to understand the moon and the planet and probably something a little bit more difficult is that it takes a personal investment. Like, I don't like things snapping inside of my head. I don't know about you, but I've made sure that this is perfect, that McDonald's is grand, and there's no more abandoned temples anywhere that I can show you myself. So, how many planets are there? There's Venus that I tried to explain briefly. You have to put some of them up in the air. Some of them come to you. Three of the planets that come to you are called Jupiter, Saturn, very high in the sky, and there's Uranus. Uranus is the most interesting planet that we could probably discuss, maybe. The Catholicism, you can discuss Catholicism, but there's a mountain there, and he's right there right now. So if I get a pizza, old pizza, cold pizza from last night, and I put it away for tomorrow, that has nothing to do with holding this dragon. Now, here's the part that gets expensive. I'm running my mouth and running my mouth. Well, yowza, you know, yowza, okay? Well, what happened was is that it burned up, and they start talking, and you can hear them talking over there. You can hear them talking over there. So now I'm a rabbi. Why are they talking to me? This also causes schizophrenia. So by holding a big dragon, I can make the whole town go crazy. Oh, and that doesn't really make sense unless you're following what people are trying to tell you about. Well, you know, dad is sick and just don't talk to him until he's better, you know. Where is this taking place? There must be 10,000 different houses over there, and there's nothing here. I mean, even further, it doesn't take much to understand that there's nowhere to bury all these people. It kills me. I don't know. So I'm staying here with the dragon. Stay here with the dragon. Not Allah, but stay with the dragon. You mean you believe in Catholicism and you don't trust Jesus Christ? I believe Jesus Christ. He's standing over there right now. But nobody ever talks about themselves. Nobody ever talked about them. You're shameful. We can do better than this. We can do better than this. That's Uranus talking right now, not, or it could be a key. You have to have the key. You have to have the key. Now, I don't like listening to all of this, but you're starting to hear what I'm saying, aren't you? You're starting to understand that it wants to take possession of you. It's abusicating schizophrenia, and it's absolutely terrible to have to understand this at the same time. Like, this is happening to us now. This is happening to us now, and there is nothing we can do about it. And I can't step forward any further than this. Unless it penetrated me and it turned into a key. So I grabbed it. I saw a picture. And I'm now a cabal. Well, you know, we need to lift this up and fix it. We need to fix it. We need to find where the moon is. The moon, not the sun. The moon. Okay, so the way that we're going to start our day today is rather simply, I fell all the way down to the bottom and there's no way back up unless you go back to Venus. I don't know where that dragon's going, honestly, but boy, there's an awful nice friend whispering in my ear. Let's go with her today. Pull her down like this, and I make her snap. Okay, now turn it into a bar. This is absolutely critical. Turn it into a bar. Yeah. And here she is. Well, good afternoon here too. We don't have any more time for this, and my mind is slowly floating elsewhere. How could that be? Well, you know, you don't have to stay with her. There's another way that the animals showed me. Do you want to turn into an animal? On and on and on and on. Jewish, Jewish, Saturn, Saturn of Jupiter. Oh my God. Well, that, it's really dumb. The cat showed me the way out. That came off of me right now, and all you gotta do is wave your hand like you have a fan or something. Okay, now try to hold that and use that instead of whatever it is that you're trying to explain. Obviously, you know, I've taken on a different personality here, but I'm no actor. That's rather stupid when you really think about it. Here's the job of an actor. Da 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 da, and we go all the way down to the bottom, and you're trying to. I want this role. I want the role of that snapping noise right there. But there's only so far you can go when you've only read all these lines, and you try to become this person overnight sometimes, and it's. Becoming an actor is obviously very, very difficult without God's help. And he will help. I don't know how that happened, but Yahshua. That's it. And if I see you on the roof, I'm coming after you. Okay, so let's forget about that and just think about a wheel turning around slowly, and we're going to go into town with our friend. You hear some of these idiots, what the problem is. You caused this to happen. Schizophrenia. Oh, God. Well, that's not necessarily true. It could be, he could be a Buddhist. He could be a Hindu. He could be a Jewish person. He could be turning right on Salerno Road, so get rid of that woman. Yeah, you know, I really think so. We're coming up to the traffic light here, and it sounds like to me that there's a lot of contention. I think he is. I think he turned right on Salerno Road, and, there's nowhere else to go. That's what I think. Yeah, you know, so I'm not a trans babe. I'm going into Winn-Dixie to pick something up, right? Transgender. Well, you gotta stop. This is Allah. Anyway. I want to keep this. I don't know about you. You know, the dad's sick, and I don't know. Just, you gotta keep track of where. Allah is. I'm having a really difficult time, and I'm only gonna explain this to you once. Don't show me that ever. Okay, so we can't discuss this any further for this simple reason. Unless you want to invest in a really expensive set of drums that you made yourself, and they're drumming and drumming and drumming, and it turns into the whole of Africa. Africa. There's Alex. He's right there. I have the key to a living person. Our friend is not good enough. The animals are good enough, but our friend is not good enough. We need a new friend. No, we don't have a friend. Basically, where is your driver's license? Where is your passport? I have one right here. All you need to do is, you know, the little blinking lights. Little blinking lights. If you close your eyes and ask Olive, just briefly, excuse me, where is this? And look for little dots of light. Those little dots of light mean you have to wait. Please wait. Please wait, because what are you stopping me for? I have to go somewhere to Venus or something like that. But right now I'm on the planet Uranus, using very expensive gypsy tears to connect to Uranus. You can barely hear this drumming or this what that is a mood. I don't belong to the tribe. I don't have a path. Yes, you do. This little dot of light. Okay, well, I don't care. That's still not the one that I want. I still don't understand this. Don't you have some animals to put on Noah's Ark? We could try to sell him an animal. Over there in the divot of the desert, there's a little dip, and inside of there is where he lives. So maybe you could try to sell him a bird. Could you sell him a duck? No. No. You can't. It's impossible. Alright, so now we're Buddhists. I don't know what to tell you. I mean, okay, doing the best I can, but women like this stuff. I mean, where did this come from in the first place? Women. Like, there's a duck inside of my head, you know. You need to try to connect the duck to Uranus just briefly and see what he wants to tell you about whatever it is that he's talking about. It says, may I humbly remind you that the emissary from the Kingdom of Africa has already spoken to you, and you are free to roam the Gambia as you wish. Although there are restrictions. African royal. So in other words, you wouldn't want to be excommunicated or anything like that. So there's friends in Africa. You can make a friend of Africa. They've explained it backwards and forwards for thousands of years, and it's just what it is. But you know, African royal. Do you see the gazelles over there? You cannot. It's impossible to get up this hill without starting the engine. Think about that. Think about where we are. All right, I'll tell you. We're in Australia, mate. All of a sudden, because I'm not hallucinating, but I could have sworn that that was an entire mountainside. He has something to say about this. It's unbelievable. You can take that entire mountainside that you just saw over there. I mean, it was just over there a minute ago, right? And turn it into a light picture, translucent, like that. That's Uranus right there. We're waiting for our ride out of here, but that's not quite good enough for me, is it? So I give up. What the crap is this? You know, I was lying. Okay, so They're exploding all over the place, and you better know where Allah is, and you better belong to the tribe to which you come from. That's the way to do it. But we're not concerned about that today. Okay, you have to be careful all day long, all day long. You can blame Allah, but he's giving up. He said that you can't sell them anything anymore, and it's just, all right. That's not true. It just happened to be that way today, because if you look up into the sky and the moon is there in the middle of the day, this is very hard to believe. You have to take one of those and put it on the moon and somehow get away from the planet Venus. All right, so that's why you should be excited about astrology and what astrologers do. Don't laugh. Because you'll be here the rest of your life if you don't understand what I'm going to do is discuss. Hey. Did you hear her there? Did you hear her there? Did you hear that? Did you hear that? You need to take it gently and lift it into the air. And it sounds like a bomb. But we need a reader to read the caller ID on the phone. So, without going over too much and discussing some of your papers, you have to be serious about this. We're going to the swamp. Mate, we're going to the swamp and you gotta find something awful. You gotta find anal gas, a fart, a flatulent that came out of your anus, to read the number on the screen. Some of them smell terrible. Some of them smell better than most. But they're all flatulent, and they pass through your system. Your system, not somebody else. What else has passed through your system? Okay, and what you're looking for is a snake. You need to find a snake, okay? And I'll throw this out the side of my teeth, but I'm not using my teeth anymore. You know, it's a snake, it's a turtle, and it stinks. And the centuries old, turtles, snakes, reptile. You have to go inside the reptile house. And this is a terrible secret because we've already shown you how awful it is, you know, on and on and on. We can do this the hard way or the easy way. It's really up to you, unless you do have a key already. Assuming that you don't, you have to get a reader. Alright, mate. So she's a beauty. She's an absolute beauty. And I'm trying to sell you something from outer space, okay? And what did she say to you? Blow the turtle shell out. Blow the turtle shell out so you can hear. Does that make sense so far? Well, you know what? I can't seem to get the camera. Okay. Straighten out here. Okay. Okay. So they have did something really dirty, something awful, okay? I'm not wearing tan. I don't have a tan uniform. And I'm not gonna spell it out any further. S-A. It's tan. I have a tan uniform. There's people talking to me and it's abusicating and I don't like it. And they've turned it into gates. Gates? So, if the ground here turns tan, that means get the hell away from it right now. I mean right now. I'm telling you, it works the same way. It works the same way. The man holds the gatepost open. And I'm running out of batteries. I don't know what I'm doing. On and on and on. the sun is very powerful, in other words. And this woman has walked past, and she doesn't have a key to the door. And she says that, I could care less what it is that you're saying, and I would rather not hear the rest of the program, and so on and so on and so on and so forth. It works the same way. That if you hear this stuff and it's bothering you, then just lift it up and put it there. That's the planet Venus. Remember I showed you where the door is. This is something entirely different. It's a security door. So the answer to the question is, the dragon has installed a security door. The dragon has installed a security door. We don't understand it, because when you see the moon in the sky like that, they're going to their depth. They're going to the depth of wherever they can, and it disappears. The moon in the sky disappears. All right. We believe you. We believe you, but you're not going to be able to get over one of those mountains. They need the police control the lawlessness when that sort of thing happens. Wait a minute, I am the police. No. It's just an acronym for trained people that understand how to do it, and they want to invest in themselves or what have you. But I have a staff and a rod, but if you poke this through the hole there, and you target what I just talked about, you know, I saw a man. I'd like to remind you that you're free to go and travel through the country of Gambia without any problems, just so long as you keep an eye on the African broil. Now, where is that? Very, very frightening things happen when you do that. So don't ever do that again. Knowing what we know now about the planet Venus. Oh, God, I am sick of the wood. It's called the wood. Don't go near the wood. Just an awful place with ATM receipts that read $250. I mean, can you just stop? No, I can't. All right, I can't. So you naturally, you may ask, you know, what? Okay, how many times did this happen? How many times have you seen the moon in the sky like that? Oh, since I've been here, about 7 times. 7 times my folly. You better get a hold of that dragon. That's all I can say. Okay, so bye. You don't have a key, do you? All right. Bye-bye. You want to say bye-bye, use the security door. Hold the security door instead of the planet Venus. It's now a planet. That beautiful whistling is willow and a willow tree. Planet Venus. The planet, isn't it? So in other words, some jerk went on and on and on further to say that they're called psychopaths. You're a psychopath. You're a psychochromatic. We're going to die. You know, like if you turn your face purple and just hold that, you're going to die. So that means automatically you're going to this color whether you like it or not. That's a terrible, terrible kind of situation to put yourself in. But it's called psychopathy. This is so hot inside of my head that it turned into thoughts. I'm not thinking about anything. I didn't do anything to get here. It's Almighty God. So you know what else he said before he left? That they have schizophrenia. This is the fault of a little squirrel hopping through the forest, and I'm gonna shave it off my nose like that, and we're gonna get out of here, and that's that. That's called Judaism. There it is. There. So also, you can become very angry about this, and that's called psychotic. You can't get any worse if you take antipsychotic. Help yourself. Suit yourself. There's something else he has to say about Jesus Christ. Suit yourself. He came here for no other reason than just to obfuscate the truth of this confusion, because he doesn't understand it. I'm going to the nuns. I don't know. She sent me outside. You're going outside, and I'm going to send you to the nuns. All right, so if you fall down here, I hope you're not going anywhere for several months if you talk to these crazy people about anything, because of the planet Venus also. I mean, I'm perfectly capable. You could call it powers of two. Powers of two. But that's just a very difficult situation. Very, very, very difficult. It has to be described by somebody. Somebody is in charge of all of this. His name is Jupiter. Jupiter and Venus don't like one another. No excuse for this. This is really fecking awful. It's closed on Sunday. Sunday is not necessarily my day. Alright, so yeah, you might want to watch out. People are pointing. Pointing. Pointing is the same thing as. Or that. Or your best friend. So today, Jupiter points the way. So that's fine. Can I have my wrist back now, please? Please? Please, do you understand? I can't move this. And it turns all blue, and there's a big snake. Get away from me! I know exactly what you can do. I know exactly what you can do. Step forward. Step forward. And then stand on your wrists. Even though you're not standing on them right now. Stand on them. Push. And it makes these little bands of air. Air that goes around the band. Now, stand on those bands. Oh, that's much better. Now I can see what I'm doing. What are you supposed we should do in this kind of situation? There's really nothing I could do to reconcile myself with myself unless myself participates. Free will. Are you ready to do the will of others? Are you ready to be an astrologer? This is goddamn serious. long prayers, okay? The same as the Yiddish person, except you're talking to Jupiter. And you'll never understand this because somebody is in charge. And he's gonna just cut you loose there if you're not paying attention. Those prayers are too long. What do we do now when the God the Father is coming against us? It's God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Will you walk towards this wristband like that? And now you won't, burn us up. That's all we're worth. So, unless you have a way out, I have a way out, even if I'm not standing on my own wrist. The problem is that we believe Allah, we believe Uranus, and most of all, we believe the sun. Sun is there, so don't. I'm also gonna put my eye out if I keep talking and making these prayers. See what just happened there. If you don't have a key to open this door, then this is not a joke, and you're going to be left out here with a bird. Here, there's a bird. Wildlife photograph. Would you like to make wildlife photographs from when you were happening? Alright, so if you noticed that I was talking in Roman, I don't know, it sounded very well. But maybe you should stand on these wrist guards sometime so you understand that you've been eaten by a snake and there's nothing we can do. But there is something you can do. You can find Venus and become a dynamo or whatever there is that they're doing now, or whatever edict that they make. Or you could talk to the camera like this. I know that Val Kilmer wouldn't have it any other way, but I'm not studying for one of his parts, you know. So you're going to have to wait with Jupiter for some time before we really kind of make a serious attempt to hear the things that I have described and come to this place. But you have to do something else besides. So that's the end of today, and that would conclude Astrology 102. I invite you to study Introduction to Advanced Astrology. Venus will not let you go from here. Take the wristband. Stand on them. 300 fan. Jupiter is God. God. So, the elongated prayers and so on and so forth, and Uranus has lent us some of his wisdom. So it's only by Uranus's grace that we're able to see what Jupiter really wanted to say about this right now. That's enough Venus for today, thank you. But you can also lay the board in front of. But that really what I wanted to cover today is how important Venus is, and who is in charge of all of this. It's quick and it's curt. And it's a thin red line. It's what else did they say? It's the difference between are you really an animal? Because I've covered this before. See, there's a problem there. You need to understand, first of all, that this is Astrology 102, and I'd really like to cover some more information about different religions. Here's Uranus. God bless you. There's nothing more to say about that than some kind of terrible argument about having a key. So we have the key because it's penetrated and gone through my nose, straight through. Oh boy, is that a lousy argument or what? Well, Jupiter, I'm tired of it. You realize that, going over this and over and over. I've come here to see this. I'm doing the best I can, but I'm not covered this information properly, so I'm going to put together some tests, and I feel like it's not really fair to leave you with an hour program about an introduction to advanced astrology and in all practicality. I showed you how to do this with Uranus. So the next course is called course Astrology 103, where we would actually cover what would happen when we were actually having the feast of Jupiter, because we can't have one now, obviously. I'm tied up in the moment, you know. Jupiter is right here. All around you, all the time, and it's about Venus, and what Uranus has said is down there, way down there. I can, you know, faintly hear maybe what he's talking to me about. But Uranus brings fire. Jupiter comes to you. Thank you. Did you know there's angels in heaven? All right, well, witchcraft and sorcery and demons. Oh boy. I think I'll put up my wall already. But you gotta do this, very true. Willow wanted to be an actor and he cut the scene the way he needed to do it, but he left the serious part out. Alright, here we go. Put up there. God the Father. So was the Father, Paul said. Well, you gotta find the moon now. Where is it? The last one. Oh, okay. We get to use the lake today. See the sun's rays right there. That's all the way up. Now we go to the planet Venus. Right there. And you have to hold this all day long. You get the whole thing. You get evil, you get good and bad and all this kind of stuff. But it acts like a screen, so you can't really see it. Now you're gonna hear all kinds of voices and things like that, and he's gotta bail. No more time. Alright, so now we gotta wait, you know, for Venus to come down and show us what she wants to do today. Usually you can see them on the palm fans much better. Yeah. It says, why don't you wear your breasts? Okay, so here's three important planets. Venus. I'm your Venus. I'm your desire. Uranus, okay. Jupiter, we briefly discussed that. I suppose we'll have to discuss it more. And finally, the Sun. The Sun. So, look at this piece of tire. There's a tire under here somewhere. If I were you, I would stare at the tire. the tire. It's grand, you understand? So, this has caught my eye, my attention is, you live in a dreamland and there's nothing you can do about it. Nothing you can do about it. But there is something you could do about it, says Uranus before he rains fire on the entire world. Is it? You have to remember where you went to sleep. Do you remember where you went to sleep last? The Sun does. Do you believe that? The Sun remembers where you went to sleep last. Okay, so this is very dangerous to discuss also, because Jupiter doesn't care for it. And he's gonna turn away like that. He'll turn away. And then we've left Rome, and there's the Sun. And you're gonna, after you're done staring at this tire, you're gonna see a wavy lines like this. They look just like the Sun. Except the Sun has come down. And then you use this as the screen. Not the one in the sky. The one in the sky can connect to Venus. And tell you where to sleep. See how my complexion has changed? That's only a couple days. I don't care where you live. I don't care what you do. I don't care that the moon is in the sky in the middle of the day. See the moon there? I don't know if this is a good sign or a bad sign, but this during the day, if it stays there much longer, we're gonna be in trouble, but it usually just appears. Led Zeppelin. One of the songs that he plays is called Black God. It means that the beast of Jupiter is half-hearted. The man in control of basically a whole lot of things is absent. What? Black dog. There's literally a black dog hanging on the side of the door there. So what you do there is have the beast of Jupiter, but we can invite guests. I mean, we don't want to invite guests to a methamphetamine party. We don't want to invite guests to a cocaine party. We're not having a pornographic convention, for example. We're not having smoking outside the door. We're not having, can you hear what I'm saying? This is Jupiter. So, Black God. Connect to the Black God hanging on the side of your door. Connect to the tiny little hallucination. It's no longer a hallucination, is it? Why is he a dog? Why, he says, why am I a dog? Why am I a turtle? Why am I the subject of your amusement? Well, I don't think it's amusing to look at the little desert skate there for no reason. It upset my sleep. This is some sun symbol. If I were to stay asleep here, then of course I couldn't go there any longer. And if you find out where there is, you're going to be horrified. It looked like a mist in a vision, and a perpetual fog, and you walk through the fog. And these two places don't connect. I mean, don't cross right now. So in other words, the sun has sent us a message. Don't listen to any voices today. That's him talking to you right now about that. There's people lost in this fog, is what he's trying to explain. Desperately. You need to convince these people to college with you, not have them strung along. Okay, so look, we're very lucky we don't have to cross. You'll hear this time and time again that I don't want to cross, and don't look at the camera, please. Don't look at my face. I don't concentrate on my face. Just talk, please. Oh, God. You know, because I'm coming before you. But there's somebody coming after me. That's a lot to cover. But I'm sure he can handle it. Yeah. Wow. I mean, are you ready for this? It looks like a wave pool over there. Do you want to go to sleep over there? We'll have to go through it very slowly, but how to become the planet Venus? How to become the planet Jupiter? How to become the planet Pluto? How to become Saturn? It's very important to promote people. Actually hear these guys talking, and it's not funny anymore. It's a comic book store, okay? So, you know, I have something to say about it. but you could go over all of this stuff, you know, just like that, no problem at all. But what I wanted to say was this. The pharaohs in Egypt have kept slaves. Rome has slaves. Egypt has slaves. America no longer keeps slaves. But it was only 200 years ago. What I'm talking about happened thousands and thousands of years. So, you know, this story is very old. There we go again. But you know, it's going to be Up. You want to see a movie called Up? You know what he's talking about? Do you know what he's talking about? You're going to hear it in your head, ringing in your head. Adonis. You can imagine some of the names of the other gods that have crossed this river. The extremely terrible. But we're going to put the moon there. Wow, okay, there's a national scandal on that guy. What are you gonna do now? Oh boy, the tire. Remember the tire. We're using the tire. Okay, and if anything goes wrong, you can always email me or call me, and I'll be happy to answer any of your questions, because I can talk and talk and talk and talk and talk and talk and talk. And we're gonna get somewhere. I remember when I told you that I don't like the things like that happening inside my head. But you know, you have other problems. Let's all go to Bucky's. Bucky's a fantastic store. You know, there's a picture of a beaver like this, and I'm driving. I'm not, not too much. Not. You know what? Something awful happened. A pinpoint snapping in my head, and I'm of course I'm 100% white, and it probably tortures me to death and murders the entire monastery. But you know, these people did some very serious things for this reason. So. Very serious thing. I guess who knows how to do this? Guess. Just guess. An Irishman. I'm an Irishman. So if you see him, he knows what you're talking about. This isn't that hard to do. I know what I'm talking about. I covered it with a tire. I'm using this tire every single day in the hope of maybe finding out some of these other things. I'm doing some of these other things. But you know, the pharaoh is very smart, and we want to roll the credits, and we can sing a song to the tree over there, but nothing is going to stop this. So we need a symbol for this. Nothing is going to stop this from happening. Dear God, I hope I never have to cross the river. Do not cross the river. What this is about. The entire story passed. had nothing to do with college. It had nothing to do with Protestant Christian. You know, Jesus Christ, he put it in reverse. He says, come to me. What? You go that way. You go. You wait until you see this. So obviously, you never finish this program without the power of Saturn. The power of Jupiter is standing on top of the mental health center. You better watch out. Because Jesus may be standing there. He may be standing here. But, you know, what will he do with his time over some of theirs? They don't know. Some of them don't make it to where. So, a foggy kind of place. And it's very scary to walk by yourself. So you can surmise some of these things, but not all of them. Some people may have a direct approach to solving some of these problems. For other people, for money. Popes and kings. But one of the eyes that I captured was from the. It's right here. Does it make you look better on camera? You get a freebie from the movie set and paint your eyelash with it. You may be able to. Alright, so you know that people are really nasty, and you can sum it up in three words pretty much about this, me talking for nearly an hour to try to explain to you what I'm talking about. Here's the pill factory. My hand is very hot. Oh, it's very, very hot from doing this. Pill factory. Okay? And there is the river. That's the river they're talking about. That came from the sun. It's called, you know, an oasis. You like oasis or blur? But it gets worse. Don't talk to me. Stop talking to me. Are you talking to me? So I've done this for a very long time. Take your palm of your hand, and then today it's right there. But tomorrow it might be in your eye. And you can't get it out anymore, and your skin turns black. Well, that's why. We have plenty of time to talk about anything other than cutting the door. Alright, I would go to bed and do this, but before bed, and when you wake up in the morning, the coffee will be ready. Usually it comes down today, but it's here today. But I need to explain something. What's inside of the cup to the planet Uranus? Uranus is very low to the ground, and it makes a very loud noise, you know. That's just one drum. It could be drumming, it could be God himself, but it usually is before he brings fire. So what I wanted to say was this. You have to stop talking to me, first of all. don't cut the door anymore. And here's what happened, okay? You have to wait. Please wait. And don't discuss this ever. It's written in the book somewhere where Jesus said that, you know, you can see Moses and Elijah, and he gives you a wafer to eat at Catholic Mass, and they have the Last Supper, and you drink the wine. And you can go even higher than that. The planet Jupiter is lovely, but you know, this Saturn, we can go to Saturn right now, and I thought that I could discuss this, but it's so powerful. So powerful, it feels like OxyContin, you know. Not benzocaine, you know. What is the prescription drug that I was in the emergency room for? One of my teeth. It's something like that. Is when you want to wait. You want to wait for him, right? Well, you need an eye. You have to have an eye for it. And there's a white eye, and there's a blue eye, and there's a red eye, and there's a dangerous animal over there. And you want to escape this dangerous animal. And the animal's blind completely, you know. So the animal's coming towards you, and we're all in Australia, you know. So you wait there, and you slowly walks by. So you have to wait and do quite a bit more than just Jupiter here. You know. So watch out for Jesus there, up the steps. And it makes a picture, but it doesn't quite make a picture of the wind, it doesn't. Put one of these onto the moon in the sky in the middle of the day, and I make a picture on the moon. So listen, it's really simple. You take the OxyContin that you ate and put it on one of the voices. So he's always with, he always has something to say, pretty loud. For me, I'm crazy. You can just lock me up and put me in there and give me all kinds of pills. This is very concerning, you know, all they got left is little eye.
Hey, help. You're terrible.
Don't cut the goddamn door. The black guy over there told you.
It's really simple.
Always, always listen to your father. He's the one that comes from. Another part of that story. So, we may also have a visitor. We have a visitor. It's only so long that we can discuss this. Listen.
Shit, where is this? I don't know anymore. I don't care. Oh my god.
Damn it. This sound is. Let me explain that again.
You see that?
Okay, so you get your keys, you know, keys like this, and it makes a flashy thing. And you say, put on your eye like this. There it is. You say, Pyro, excuse me, where the hell is it? Yeah. Because it doesn't know.
You'll kindly tell us.
We're looking for I see something there. Something over there. No, don't go. Oh, okay. Okay, right over there by the tree there, here's a safe way. And unfortunately, we're only 12 years old today. Yeah, good for you, your eyes are still good. You have any idea how bad it is. So you see it for yourself. Visitor.
So listen up, I'm 43 years old and I've been abducted and this is my story.
No. So although, you know, encounters of the third kind are rare, it usually has to do with it.
Don't come near me. They don't like
it. See the blue there? Step away from the blue. Tip. Listen, see how tall that guy is? I can't get this on camera again, but see how tall he is? Just looking for slaves. Alright, look, there's another one. I'm not kidding with this. I mean, I don't know. Still raining. This is how tall that shopping cart is.
Anyways, listen, this is how tall that shopping cart is.
See all the idiots who want to get around your head? You need the symbol right now.
So obviously, you know, this is very, very, very hard.
Excuse me, Rabbi. You have to put it there. Put it there. Come on. Just go.
Let's go.
It wants to go from there to back to that. Don't cross the river. Can you just come on?
So one small step for man.
Jesus is behind us now. We have to go down the steps. Down a step to find your spouse or husband.
Welcome to Italy. This is our lovely car. Oh.
God, this is getting stupid. How stupid can people be? Here he is.
Okay, so, you gotta have wine for this to work. Not necessarily alcohol, but wine.
Alright, so I got a steak. Steak is ready. I got a steak.
taken ready. Cooking it up real good. Got me just a bit of barbecue. Real simple. I'm gonna blast off and out of the pan.
All right, so the ground we turned over is over there, so you can hear it. It's loud and it's red, and it's low. I know what all of this stuff is, and I make the marker. Stop. Okay, now connect the marker to the ground you turned over. And I'll give you a new. But before you do that, you gotta kneel on the ground. You ask them, what can we eat? He's always here. No, not that. Maybe over there towards the safeway. Right there. Very careful. Don't want to eat the septic system. Right there. Okay, well, it looks like there's a leftover steak there with him.
Okay, so it feels like a really low.
See my eyes were
frozen kind of cock. And there's our first customer. It's a little blip like this where we'll stay here until he tells you about for sure. When you have to drink some wine. Cause it doesn't change if you have it in a cage.
Alright, well, listen, I have to be really careful because that is God the Father. He's over there. You want that one? So, you know, he just kind of walks through here like I'm, you know, in the window.
Alright, so, anyway. Allah. God. Told that man something terrible. It's like screaming at somebody. Here he is.
I would have the same face and everything. So that's the way you can look at it. Don't look at it at all.
So, we finished the piece of Jupiter, and we're able to speak to the lower houses. And when I say speak, they come up from the ground, but because we had this installed, then you're able to freely speak to them. Where otherwise you have to come down here a bit with the Jewish people. And he comes back and he says, hey, I have a rain check for this. Well, what do you think about that? What do you mean, what do I think about it? You mean to say that you've seen him already and this is what he said?
Alright, so, you know, why am I telling you this? Why am I talking about this at all? You know, you can see how complicated it is. But You don't have to look there if you don't want to. But it's just fair warning. Don't talk to me. Don't talk to me. And I probably have to conclude by saying, in the next part, we'll move on to the feast of Saturn, which is a bit different. Instead of a gaseous expanse there inside of your head, Saturn is hard, and I won't move. Wow. No matter what happens, I won't move. And then there's Pluto. But right now, we're going to have to explain Venus. And it is hard. Okay? So, you can talk to the lower houses as much as you like, but you have to remember something very serious. I gotta go somewhere and I can't tell you where I'm going. I have an eye for it. It's white, blue, but I've used the blue one from Twilight. I was able to come back to a place that doesn't really exist. Because I've already done this before and I've seen what's happened. And they didn't like it. So in the upper house, there's challenges. Many, many challenges. And this is probably the one of them right now. You know, I'm a great actor. I'm a professional athlete. I've won 6 gold medals, and I'm not telling you the truth, am I? So there's that.
One's a hazelnut and one's not. And a fresh egg. Mine's a fresh egg. So, this one here.
Alright, that's it. Raise your hand if you're confused. There's no moon. There's no moon. A new moon for no reason. I don't know what date it is. I don't know the hour. Nothing. There's a star there. We're gonna have to use that. So, look at the starlight there. Concentrate very hard for a blue light. Just a blue light after your time up. And you'll know when your time is up. And this ends the feast of Jupiter. It's just a blue, beautiful, beautiful symbol in blue. All right.
So, the name of the star is called Arcturus, and it's right there, so now we can get out. We can get out. We don't have to go anywhere. We can walk around with a straight face through all of it. And when people are talking out of turn, you can use that. Right now, use it right now. They can't see, we're blind, oh my God. You'll know when you're not. It's terrible. It's almost like being completely blind suddenly. Okay, now it's time. I'm tired of this. I don't want to do this thing. Jupiter. Jupiter, the planet Jupiter. So Jupiter actually says that this is not for me, it's for you. I won't let them steal your stomach again. This stuff is making me sick. God. So you can see how very serious this actually is, you know. You can steal the Wi-Fi from Books a Million, I don't know. But, you know, but sometimes people talking, you know. I'm not the first person to hear that. I'm sure I won't be the last. But... they're usually far away, you know, like a TV is playing. That's fine. That's just fine. But sometimes they make you sick. It's called being dumb. Like this person is dumb. I'd rather not speak to him or her for another week. So, this is called. Also called darkness. People on the dark side of this don't understand that you take this numbness, this oxycontin, this powerful mint Juliet, and connect it to the voice, and you discover something very strange about the voice. You should have listened to the voice from when it began. So you can get on the right bus. Okay, so the sun is gonna rise tomorrow. We're going to sleep. And you better be fast about this. Everybody knows that you better run like an Indian. Really fast. There's no other way to explain it. Venus is probably the closest way to understanding what you have to do next. Despite Jupiter standing before you.
in the lower house. In the wow. Okay. Because the next contender is really, you know, Mercury.
And we can also ask the oracle, Allah. Do you remember where you put Allah? Allah remembers what he put Allah. But, you know, it just goes on and on and on. But we can try with the new symbol that goes over your growling stomach. Your stomach starts to growl. Put that there. Put that there. But we're going to sleep. And when we wake up, something weird is going to happen to you. I cannot describe. So, we're going to show you how to do Venus rather than jump to Saturn. I'll say, okay, so I washed all my clothes and I've been a good boy, so I'm going to ask them now. It is very difficult to accept some of the answers, so you have to be very careful. What does the symbol mean? It means the captain's watch was set by the pirate flag. Please don't fly the pirate flag over the stupid video game, World of Warcraft. We believe that the progenitor is a teddy bear all. Ride your bicycle carefully. Even though you work for a government office, there are other forces in control of your new yo-yo. Remember to be careful with the basketball. And don't put it near the toilet. Because I don't have any money for false teeth. But, you know, all of that, you could just kind of think about what that means. It's very hard, especially Arcturus, it's a Greek star. So, what does that mean? What is it going to be? This is how it's going to be. And you know, Arcturus is thousands of years old. Okay, so basically it's going to be the sun tomorrow. And we're going to have to do the night show or the night scenes. And to show the night scenes because of the Chinese influence and the, you know, the Hindus and all that kind of stuff. You can't use that anymore. Oh God, they look like bugs. The sun looks like looking at a bug, like shiny and all. I'd rather be Venus, but it says be careful riding a bicycle. So that means good luck with Venus. Or rather simply, we're standing in front of Books a Million. You know, the Catholic monks have a demon there. He says, he doesn't get good rest. You can tell him, why don't you get your rest? And we won't listen to you. All right, yeah, so you see how the trees are bending and twisting, and the ground is warping around, and it's doing stuff. It's a hobo's life for me. I don't care. Run away fast, very, very fast. But you know what you do? You use your eye, what you got last night, and you do it again. And yeah, just position that there, and then project a marker of some sort and connect it to the planet Uranus. And you're grand. But there's one little thing. Before you project it, or project the marker is from a dream you were having. It's good to dream. Do you think so? It's good to dream, but what were you dreaming about? I don't know. So basically, run like hell, and we're waiting for the sun, and he's not here yet. Okay, so basically, put the white eyeball there behind the sun. Sun. White eyeball there. The sun. Don't go down the stairs. The sun. So that would be the Native American. We're grand now. You get that extra sleep there. It makes a lot of difference. I was like, so basically, you know, picking out crab pots is not so great when you think about it. Yeah, I have some rest, but I'm a supernatural being. I'm metaphysical. I'm a strange being in a strange place. And, you know, it should stop in a minute, but if it freaks you out too bad, you know, just go back to sleep or something. But I... Yeah. You know, I've always asked myself this question, you know, what is going on over there? And they want to know, you know, you gotta close the door. George Washington, don't stop till you see the whites of their eyes. Or don't fire. Oh, yeah. You gotta be careful there, because I think he's losing his teeth. I have no idea what this is about, you know. Anything like that. That's what part of being an astrologer is. So, you know, if somebody asks you even one time, you know, what are you talking about? That's gonna be enough for me. What are you... You don't make any sense, you know, and so on. Just, I mean, what? I don't know. I don't know. There's one thing for sure, is you gotta get away from here. It'll stop in a minute or so, you know, and it'll be real weird. And I just challenge you to go try to talk to somebody after doing this. You gotta close the door. So they all shut, and he realized what a fool he had been walking around doing it. You know, remember the magic word. All of it just vanished. It's unbelievable. Can we get a tiny little word in here about your ass or something? No. No, it's gone. It's gone. That's a witch over there. It's a witch. No. No. Oh, but it's a train. Good morning. Well, he's still got some gas in it, so you can hear, you know, Native American. All right, so let me explain again. My hand is very hot, you know, and it makes a noise. You put your hand to your brow like that, and then put all that on the moon, the picture that was on the moon, on your hand. All right, look, where is that? This is getting going on here for a pretty long time. Don't cut the door. So, that doesn't help me. I'm gonna put the Smithsonian in. You know, you might have another professional. You might be working on something else, but here's.
You want a cream of sugar that's left?
A coffee.
You heard?
No, thank you.
Okay.
No, thank you. Okay. Officials, Smithsonian research. It might help Egyptian studies. But this is all you need to be concerned about for the entire day. Right there. See that? You hold that inside of your feeble mind. Oh, he doesn't like this. This is a gym. Oh, well, so much for him. Oh, you know, yes, are we reading him? So I really can't believe it, that they'll end this lecture here, but why are we doing this? So I've held the coffee all day, for weeks and weeks, I passed by, and it's really kind of difficult to understand what it is that I want to say anymore. It's just happened. It happens that, you know what happens when you stick your elbow into something you don't understand. It comes back to you. The fox says to me, "Hey, you remember driving around in the convertible of yours?" I said, "Yeah, well, we're going that way." You understand? I said, "No, I'm just petrified of how smart I am. So be careful. This could end up any which way, but not like. Not like That was 1996. So that's 20 years, and then 4 years, and then 2 more years. That's 26 years. 26 years I've been trying to understand. So forgive me, I'm on silent. People have left us. But I haven't. So, don't cross the river. Don't cross the river. Go that way. I don't know whether to be terrible or it's like some kind of outer space log or Robert De Niro is telling us about being in outer space. Don't go near outer. Danger. So, those of you who are still with me, just totally for real. Go this way. Now, what am I talking? Just turn your neck like this. You see that? What happened there? Always follow that, no matter what happens. Oh, yeah, I guess I gotta turn the battery on. Okay, one more thing, just rewind the whole thing, rewind all of it, you know, throw it out the window, forget about Walmart, forget about anything I just did in the last two hour lecture. And so this, all you need is this little symbol, one little symbol. What kind of symbol is it? It's a trend. Transparent symbol. Transparent. Translucent. And a little tiny man sitting on your shoulder. Well, they're getting a chicken and cutting its neck. You know, it's very beautiful little symbols. It's here, but it's not really here, but it's there in the white of your eyes. This is transparent, and it's on the sky. So, to recap, we want to hide from there. How are you going to... It's not yesterday's life. It's not your problem. It's not my problem. We're going that way. You see that? All the time. Just turn your neck. Always. And now we can end the program. We didn't have to press rewind and go backwards like that. But the corn is still growing. Now they're growing. But you know, what are you gonna do? Step out of the way. Doesn't he belong in the sky? How far can you see? Depends on how far you can see. Where are my exact words? That's how creepy it is. And congratulations if you understand what I'm saying now. We're going. Yay. Thank you. Thank you very, thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
So, you know, if you want to go to college, do this. There's that also. We lose again. There is Venus one more time. Can't you miss her? If you say one word. And on and on. Yeah. See if I get a zoom. Okay, let me be a little bit more clear. This is 1 o'clock in the afternoon, okay? There's the gable. 1 o'clock in the afternoon. There she is again. Be careful.
All right, so there's some professional people here, you know, so don't call me back unless I call you. Professional. They registered with King Nebuchadnezzar, the king of the Jews. Still alive. You know, even though I have an eye for my heartbeat, my doctor's off a crab pot. Don't pull up somebody else's crab pot. Because it sounds terrible, even in this place. If you want to go to college to do this, it's the same thing.
I don't know if it's going to ban us again or so on and so forth, but we need to go somewhere else tomorrow morning. Literally, leave here tomorrow morning. Go to that. What you have to do is transpose that picture that's on there that you can see onto there. So we know where we're going, but what we have to do now is like an emergency episode of Star Trek Voyage. Wait, you see the wind in the willow there? You can hear her. But there's a reason. Every single time. Okay, so we have to get down on your knees. So once you're down on your knees, I can hear her there. So I think this would be a good time. Just lift it up as hard as you can. Just hear the sound as hard as you can without anyone else disturbing you while you're doing it. If someone else is disturbing you, then that means there's even more trouble. They have to wait until they stop their timber tap about the whites of their eyes going cross and they go to the knocking board. You ready? Okay, it made a noise right there. So you're gonna have to look right here with the turtle shell, the snake. Okay, now answer that photograph. What is that? It was right here.
All right, that was really hard, wasn't it? I'm good for it. I was a little bit more afraid than I was yesterday. So you might want to ask yourself the question, how much money we want to charge for my service? Did I scare you with that? Did I scare you to the tune of several billion dollars? Several billion. Why don't you try $350 billion? So, keep your hands out of your pockets. So if you want to see this, you know, you may want to say, well, okay,
I can offer a special blessing, one of my special blessings. You know, not just my advice, but they can hear. Because I have about six of these eyes. And we're going up or we're going down. But that eye right there, the one that just told me what to say, you have to connect it to the back to Uranus. Just briefly. And you'll find out, well, you know, there's a Wendigo over there. What? You have to put a scarecrow or something like that. What if you have to say, this is my forecast for the next month? That's about how important that is. So, if you dare, you can actually see what people are doing from other worlds. It adds up. This morning I fucked an abominable person. Abominable. They move like this. Okay. Stop touching my face. Stop touching my face. It's not doing any of us any good at all. And I think that the photograph looks fine. It's just that I'd rather see something more. I'd rather see something more. So if that's what your customers are looking for, then that's certainly what you should deliver, even though they're not.